James A. Garfield, the 20th President of the United States, once said, "Things don't turn up in this world until somebody turns them up." Paleontologists and archaeologists have the unique job of discovering, or turning up, evidence from the past. While paleontologists use fossil remains to understand the past, archaeologists study the remnants left behind by ancient civilizations. Let's take a look at some of the most famous discoveries in archaeology over the last two centuries. Perched high in the Peruvian mountains, the ancient citadel of Machu Picchu remained hidden to the outside world for hundreds of years. Then, in 1911, American archaeologist, explorer, and future senator Hiram Bingham heard about rumors of an abandoned city from local farmers. Following a local guide, he climbed up and up the rugged mountain, until finally he caught sight of the ruins that would change his life. Later, he said of his discovery, "Suddenly we've found ourselves in the midst of a jungle-covered maze of small and large walls. Surprise followed surprise, until there came the realization that we were in the midst of as wonderful ruins as any ever found in Peru." In the local dialect, Machu Picchu means old peak or old mountain. This impressive mountaintop fortress, thought to be built in the 15th century, sprawls across 5 miles. It was constructed from granite stones, cut so precisely that no mortar was needed, and not even a paper would fit in between the stones. No one is completely sure why it was built in such a remote location, but scientists have speculated that it could be anything from a royal estate to a religious site, or even an isolated prison. Whatever the reason, this mysterious city with its stunning backdrop attracts 1.5 million visitors to Peru every year. This magnificent structure is the Greater Temple of Abu Simbel. The entrance is guarded by 4 seated statues, each representing the pharaoh Ramses on his throne. These massive carvings rise to heights of 35 meters, or 115 feet. The temple was carefully constructed so that twice a year the sun aligned with the door of the temple and a beam of sunlight would reach all the way into the innermost chamber. Ramses II built this temple 1200 years before the birth of Christ to display his wealth and power. The temple complex is believed to have been discovered in 1813 by a Swiss scholar traveling down the Nile. Most of the temple entrance was buried in sand and had to be excavated before it could be explored. In the 1960s, a dam across the Nile was planned, which would cause massive flooding in the temples. To preserve them, the temples were painstakingly deconstructed, moved, and reconstructed miles from the dam. This massive project took almost 5 years to complete, but now the temples are safe and available for anyone who wants to visit. In the 1930s, Edith Pretty was a wealthy widow living on her estate at Sutton Hoo in England. She became convinced that several large mounds on her land were hiding some archaeological secrets. Spurred by curiosity, Edith enlisted the help of local amateur archaeologist Basil Brown and 2 or 3 of her staff members, and instructed them to begin digging. Over time, however, this small project would become one of the most important archaeological discoveries of medieval Europe. Meticulous excavation of the mounds uncovered the remains of an Anglo-Saxon burial ship. Around 1400 years ago, the ship was chosen to be the tomb of an ancient king. It was hauled from the river, filled with treasure, and buried in the fields of what would someday become Edith Pretty's home. Inside the burial chamber in the center of the ship, they discovered gold coins, silver bowls, instruments, buckles, jewelry, and the renowned Sutton Hoo helmet. Edith, aware of the historic significance of the find, donated all the treasure to the British Museum, where it could be studied by experts. Pompeii was once a thriving city on the coast of modern-day Italy, but now it is an extensive archaeological site. The event that destroyed this city is also the event that preserved it. One terrible day, Mount Vesuvius erupted, spewing fire and ash down upon the inhabitants of this ancient Roman city. It took only hours for the entire city to be covered in over 20 feet of ash and stone. The ash that buried the city also acted as an impressive preservative. Buildings, household items, and even foods were found exactly where they would have been on the day of the eruption. The excavation of the city of Pompeii was the birth of modern archaeology. Unfortunately, the project was initially completed in a haphazard fashion, bent on the accumulation of treasure rather than knowledge. Many artifacts were damaged or destroyed in the process. By the early 1800s, the focus of the excavation changed from accumulation to preservation. The excavation and restoration of this historic site continues even today. Throughout history, explorers have unearthed tombs filled with golden treasure and precious jewelry. Qin Shi Huangdi, the first emperor of China, filled his tomb with something different. Farmers digging a well in 1974 found clay fragments that led to the discovery of over 8,000 life-size soldiers, horses, and chariots, all carefully sculpted from terracotta. The emperor had commissioned this terracotta army as he believed that it would protect him in the afterlife. Originally, each sculpture was beautifully painted, but the paint quickly disappears when it is exposed to the air, fading to a uniform reddish color. As archaeologists excavate new sections, they quickly transfer some of the statues to a lab to study the paint before it completely decomposes. This historic site draws over 1 million visitors each year. From the peaks of Peru to the coasts of Italy to the deserts of Egypt, these diverse and intriguing archaeological sites give us an opportunity to glimpse into the lives and cultures of the past. What will be discovered next, and what lessons will we learn?